I'm sitting here with lakes in a beautiful magic pond, a little community place. In order to speak this intro for this science-related eye-opener, what is about to follow is a talk with the physicist Ivo Orlich. He once was a professor for physics, and now he's retired and does science on Brazilians. And we met at the World Prana Festival 2019 in Italy, Cocore. And if you want to get to know him, watch the Lucid Dream interview video with him on Brazilians, Prana, Science and Spirituality. And it was great to have the opportunity to pack in all science-related stuff connecting shamanic realms, plant masters, bees, frequency shift, and all the stuff together and recording it. Because actually, since I finished my master in physics, of theoretical physics, I didn't have the chance to speak to any scientists since then. It just didn't happen. And yeah, I was relating a lot to scientific stuff over the years, but yeah, this is where I could place it really focused, crystalline. Yeah, and this is just the beginning, because after this great talk we had, we connected deeper and I spent one night on a scale where the weight is very detailed, measured over time, and I went into deep ayahuasca to find out about gravity effects. And during the session, it was an audio recording, and I again had to transport a lot of dense information. This will be packed in a second part. So yeah, here we go. And have a look at the video description. There you find a lot of science-related links to finally melt and unify where we come from. Yeah, step by step, evolution.
So what are your big questions?
That's not a question. I want you to listen first, and
okay,
then we can. It's about the body on multidimensional neurotransmitter that we have. We are under influence when we are in mother's womb, and when we die, and when we meditate, and when we fast for long. It's DMT is the one.
Sorry, what it is?
DMT is
DMT.
The body on thing, and I'm watching nature, and also that every physical system or biological system shows a phase transition where it reaches a critical point and then it shifts to another phase.
Okay.
Kind of same what happens with water. You have the triple point.
Yeah.
And when it is about grasshoppers, what is the trigger that before they were just individual grasshoppers, and when six neighbors touch, then suddenly serotonin is released in all at once, and this makes them a connected swarm intelligence. So what is shown to me for years through using shamanic plant medicine is again and again a kind of metamorphosis or birth process for the whole connected consciousness, where it is not anymore a vision of one, but where there could be, like in every biological system, a global release of body own DMT or 5-MeO-DMT within the whole system. What would be the omega point, time wave zero, all connecting to all, on reaching this. This is the one thing that is for me also regularly again and again shown in visions, and I have experiences of being transformed into insect intelligence, swarm intelligence, bees. Especially, I worked with 20 bee tribes. Also, found out these are very interesting creatures. There was the work of Grebennikov, a scientist. He already died, and he built out of wings of bees, a special sort of bees. He built a box where he could fly, and he could with very very fast. He could hover, and very 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 fast. He just had to arrange the wings of these bees. And this is what I also when I was doing ceremonies at the bee place. I saw that each of them is creating vortexes,
mm-hmm.
and they also map the whole world hexagonal. When you even hold one honeycomb like this, you have 3 meters in this direction and this direction. The everything mapped like the hexagons of the
really?
Combs.
You and mean the way they fly?
No, the way they fly is as well everything hexagonal, but also if you just with DMT optics active, you just see how the frequency radiates out very very largely. This is also what I experience when I open honey. Then it is not the smell; it is the frequency that informs everything around. And when you place bees in a 7-star geometry, then you can put a frequency measuring tool under the bees, and you measure that the frequency of the bees rises up over 900 hertz, and 900 everything above 900 hertz is what is also connected to the DMT frequency. When you consume ayahuasca or smoke DMT, then you hear the ear ringing. Similar to, or when you produce a body's own, when you're in dark cave experience, you hear it really loud.
Mm.
And this is what the bees then are at this frequency. And with this 7-star geometry, they form like a new collective consciousness. They are aware of themselves. There was one scientist who says they have then an I personality. They are aware of themselves. And when you, when not every piece of the corner of the 7-star is placed with bees, you can take it away and put a human there that is ill, he will heal. And he measured the frequency that the bees radiate, the frequency over a 4-kilometer range where they rise the frequency, and that the bees work better when a pranic being is around. That it is kind of. I also experienced telepathic connections to the bees. I was sleeping in the bee house, and I also telepathically was invited to completely feel the bee hive, and I could heal them from the varroa mite, which is the number one cause of bees start dying, by simply rising their frequency. Then the varroa mite not it is a parasite and it is swinging much lower, and the bees that are produced not naturally, when the bee queen makes their wedding flight, she does not rise up so high and therefore the whole tribe is lower in frequency and they will be affected to illnesses. But when you place this tribe in a 7-star, after 72 hours, they will convert to a higher frequency. And when I was with them and I was in deep ayahuasca space, I just told them, listen, and I shared the frequency with them. And afterwards, all the mites were just coming out, and afterwards they were free of it. And I experienced on this place where the bees are, it didn't even matter whether they are in a special geometry or not. They open like a portal for parallel realities of sixfold parallel scenarios. Within the blink of a second, you could see click, 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 different similar but different shapes of the trees, the bee, how is it called, where boxes, yeah. they were suddenly about half a meter, just like they put themselves on another position in the other reality. And in one reality, there were even three more additional bee boxes that we never put there. And it was always like cluck, 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 cluck. And I could experience this again, and it was not a once. And also when I went into the house with the bees, it was like in the film Howl's Moving Castle, where he has a rotating thing where you can you see this picture, you see this picture, and the next one, and you can kind of choose where it stops and where you want to go out.
Like in a dream.
Like in a dream. And when I was not there, it was standard stuff of sacred geometry, beautiful visions and all that, but always with the bees, they just showed me, or it just happened like in a mirror cabinet. And it was not just locally, but the whole area around also switched realities. And
that was during your meditation.
This was.
But you were also at that time close to the beehives, and you were surrounded by them.
Yes, I was directly surrounded by the beehives, and I repeated this often when there were portal dead days. According to my own calendar, I connected to them, and I also felt like they can lift gravity. This is like the same what Grebennikov showed, that they can. You can even show it when you placed wings of the bees. They are hovering. If you just do one fly over the other, suddenly there is no gravity. And I had to remove from the spot every kind of metal and plastic thing to make it more high frequent. And this was very, very interesting, and it also was great, because I got all the propolis and the honey from the bees, and when it is in the original form, then it has all the frequency of the mandalas of the flowers inside, and honey, how it is normally done, it is destroyed. The structure is not anymore this is what you can see one-to-one with TMT active. You just see microscopic and telescopic. This is what also was shown. Just the work of Ernst Haeckel, who was zoologist and
what are these?
These are life forms. It was 100 years ago, and he just drawed all ammonites and insects.
That.
And yes, it was. This is why it is free. He already died, so one can use his pictures. And he made this art forms of nature, where he drew it greatly.
Before the microscope.
Yes. This is what you can see with eyes, and also here there was.
But was he also taking ayahuasca? Or
no, but I guess it is the same where Hildegard von Bingen got her library of knowledge. It is also coded in mushrooms, and some people just have the connection body on, so they can just see it. Also in ayahuasca, you do not need to consume. You just get the signature of a thing, and you instantly see what it is good for, and get all the information out of it. And there is a book called Organic and Non-Organic in Comparison, which shows hundreds of foods under the microscope, the fine structure of, for example, apple, when it is non-organic and when it is organic. And when it is organic, you know, it always depicts the origin of where it comes from. So, apple tree, like in the Alhambra, the salt also, Himalaya salt, like the mountains, and sea salt, like shores. And table salt is just copy and paste, no more information inside. And here the orange tree, also with the fruits.
How are these pictures taken? Is this the...
It is...
This like a microscopic picture of...
Yes, microscopic...
Of the tissue, orange tissue.
Yes.
Did you take these pictures?
No, this is from the book, and I got the okay to print some of them. They made hundreds of those things visible, and I was just feeling happy about this, because when you in DMT state get a normal apple, organic apple, and one from the store, and you stare at it, and you apply Heisenberg's relation to be focused, you then see one-to-one also on the walnut. The structure behind the structure behind the structure. And I was 1 year just doing almost every siesta I smoke DMT. It is almost only active for 15 minutes. And I placed every material I could find, a scissor and stones. And I would look with the DMT microscopic active look on it, and I would see one-to-one what Google microscopic image, and also with metal I could see the structure of the regular pattern, and with water I could see the difference, and so much beauty in spring water, and like here, kind of the destroyed information in normal tap water. And also stones, suddenly I could see where all the esoterics are getting their information from. You have such a field, and you see it one to one. It was so amazing. And also looking into honey for example, and ghee is the Ayurvedic butter. That is, and both are can be for hundreds of years. They are good. No bacteria will make them bad. Okay. And you understand then, because honey is the most sticky thing ever. You see in the fine structure that there nothing can. It just binds. It just binds it, and you stuck there, and you never move from A to B. And in chi, it is vice versa. It is so slippery in the picture that it just goes somewhere and can never form anything that it wanted. And this plastic, it was so interesting, because when you're in this optics, everything natural is so much trippy, but it's not deformed trippy like on psilocybin or LSD. It is like reality, like... with our eyes, we see only 0.0.0, such a small spectrum. And like I call it first eye in the middle of our brain, first eye opening to the whole spectrum. And you see then everything. And also when you have raw food or seeds in water, they are so alive. And when you have cooked food, you see not much more movement. And when you have something which is under a lot of conservatory, like a burger or like salad dressing, that would never get bad for years, because so many, it is looking like I'm not tripping. I have to look long at it, and it showed no movement, no frequency, like being dead.
Mm-hmm.
And same with plastic. Everything around is so beautifully showing its pattern, and plastic is plastic. It's completely normal, and you long look at it, and also let your glance get blurry. Then you see slowest moving, longest boring story, why it took million of years to tell its story, and why it needs so long to get decomposed. An interesting thing is glass. With glass you see, you can, and also when you watch liquids through glass, you see no optics, no microscopic optics, because of the reflection, and the glass has this different structure of amorph. And it is like our eyes are also, when they are also glass, and you have to blur through it, or with glass I could not see the fine structure. It is where reflection happens.
Yeah.
It is like in quantum physics, because there measurement happens and you get exact information, but everything that is when you let your eyes. But the most interesting thing that nature placed, and what is for me the highest sacred plant and also body on information, is Salvia divinorum. This is an endogen. This plant only was found in Mexico, nowhere else. But lately it was shown that over 26 other salvia herbs also have this. It is the strongest hallucinogen in the world. It is completely different to anything else. It is shown that it docks onto the kappa receptors in the brain, and it releases a cocktail of body own cascades. Divinorum means truth speaker. It is also not active for most. For the first, when you first do it, you not feel anything like with THC. And second time, maybe also not. But then it is completely setting you out of. It is lifting consciousness. And this is the interesting thing, like in quantum, when there is no observer anymore, it is a black hole. Mm-hmm. It is time and space gets completely deformed. Time stops. You see parallel realities. You can have the experience of being in your childhood, with detailed. It is not a trippy something. Mm-hmm. It is the same realistic thing as being here.
Really?
There was
you tried it.
Yes, I tried it, and the interesting thing is that I experienced that we have a body own echo of this in us. So 80% of my experiences with salvia are without touching the substance. It was just triggered by something. I just read something or remember it, and suddenly it draws me into, and I'm completely in this universe. It is not a universe. It is a sacred plant, and the tribes call it also Scar Maria Pastora, after Virgin Mary. And there is a religion in South America that is influenced by Christianity and Salvia Divinorum, and they also call it Yerba de la Maria Pastora, because it explains her abilities to clone herself, to parthenogenesis. This is what salvia originally does as a plant. It was never found to have seeds, but it clones. Mm. And it does not need to care for it, because humans do it. Humans make...
You're writing about that in
yes,
your book.
Yes, yes, this is why it is so interesting. Let's see. Yeah, here. So here is this... recreation by cloning, and in Wikipedia it is said that parthenogenesis also happens with spiders, with whales, with birds. Different animals can it, and of course many plants can it. And it happens that there is several hormones are playing the unfertilized egg cell. They are playing the illusion of fertilization, okay. And suddenly it starts to clone. It is just a hormone that is triggering it. It is same thing that what the sperm does. It is just activation and energy, and suddenly it starts to clone. And what salvia does is the same thing, but for realities, for multiverse. This is why Stephen Hawking's multiverse M theory is on the same page as the salvia effect, because his description of putting an astronaut into a black hole is one-to-one the experience of what hundreds of people. It is nothing is more cinema-like and more thrilling than reading salvia. Salvia trip reports on how reality is. You get split by half, and like a zipper, and time stands still, and you have the experience also to be suddenly a flower, to be suddenly a brick stone, to be another person, even to be your mother, to be a girlfriend who you just before watched a photo. And also very common is in the deepest state that it is complete amnesia in the first moments. You do not know that you're a human, what you did. It's just you broken reality. You cannot, you have no word. It is, and time and space hangs. It runs through you. And it is, the whole body starts vibrating. And not only the body, but the whole environment. This is the biggest thing of realizing multiverses. And I was then guided to combining deep DMT space in DMT. I feel it is activating phi, the golden ratio, in every cell. And it is also making the whole body harmonious. Every organ has a resonant frequency, eigenschwingung, eigenstates.
Yeah.
And before it cleans out all the beds, the lower frequencies, and then it is all in harmony. And then you are kind of connected to a swarm intelligence, and there's no I anymore. You're one with everything. And this oneness then decides to put all, not only the human awareness, but the all awareness of your you see everything multidimensional split up. And this then is like putting God into black hole. And this felt like the evolution of God happening there, and you... And Terence McKenna says Salvia has morphogenetic and synchronistic properties. That it is like cloning every cell, and you see yourself. It is like the multiple you theory, and you see, you just think about something, and you see. Like a zipper, and you think I need to go to tell my parents that I broke reality, and you see a part of you standing up and going there, and just like, and you then be back, and it is, and you can also think about any life form. So I used the method of first writing a note before going into Salvia, what I want to do there. You will forget that you wrote a note. You will forget what letters are. You cannot read. But making this intention before, making you in the experience, remembering it, and I could really depuzzle everything. And within the space, I was told the story of life, and also the derivation of immortality, how it called itself. It was like you have fire. Phi is the swarm intelligence. It's all life. Phi also every reproduction is always golden sexual in the golden sexual in the golden sexual. When a woman is pregnant, you have golden sexual in golden sexual. And also, when you watch a tree, everywhere a sprout is, it is always in the sacred relation. So,
but how is it in the womb with the woman? Where is the sacred section? You said that it's
when you just would take a photo and take the proportion of woman to fetus, it would always be in the same. Like this is why we where beauty comes from. What we find beauty is when it is very very nicely, like when a flower and all this. And light is also phi. When phi tries to delete itself, putting off no more consciousness. So you have phi going to zero, and zero is the circle, is the birth, and then it clones. You have two of it. So once you, if you want to kill life, it you just get put it through the zero, through the basic reproduction. What and what I experienced in Salya, when consciousness is not there anymore, no more observer, then suddenly all is cloned. Every cell is cloned. All realities is two-dimensional slices, and this is how it is preserved. You cannot, light cannot not be, and in the moment of annihilation, it is just double. This
very is difficult to comprehend or follow it.
So it is. This is the form of the spiral worm, that also has the cloning and amputation ability. Mm-hmm. Wherever you put it,
cut
it, it is. And also this one is remembering a lot of what you see in Salvia with reality within reality, with the, like in the Marushka
puppets.
And
this is a plankton, or what is this, or a seed, or what is it?
It is a shell from in the rivers. There are small ones. This is one of Georg Haeckel's drawings.
I see.
And yeah, this is just very interesting. Like also here are microfilaments in cytoplasma, and you have. And everything of this cytoplasma around our cells are closed tubules, and is topologically closed. So topologically closed means it is a closed manifold.
Yeah.
One example is also a circle or a torus, and within one closed manifoldness, it is the same what you literally can see under influence of psychedelics. You see a lot of these closed toruses and one-to-one expressions. That is why it is so, and this is what you then, you not just see it, you are it. This is, and when you watch the skin, you would see something like this and
you
everywhere.
Drawing most amazing. Wow, you have so
patterns.
Much experience with all this.
This is the theory of Nassim Haramein, you know, black holes
in the proton.
Also that we living inside of a black hole, that makes so much sense. And there was something like a world formula coming to me just by words. And it's 84. The basic structure of infinity is circle, spiral, and torus. The mapping or projection of infinity works with fractals, meaning it is alive and nothing is alone. The big maps, the small, it's the holographic universe principle. The big one encapsulates the small and vice versa, and zero and infinity. And the interesting thing is when I mapped this to the plant masters, it was it's called Building Box God. Humans are many torus measuring stations. Torus geometry, and we are measuring. DMT is fractal sacred geometry. This is one of the ingredients. Sacred geometry includes spiral, torus, circle, and fractals.
Okay.
And Salvia Divinorum is the black hole is the zero,
okay.
as well as in infinity, and so connecting these two together.
So what are we doing in this 3D reality? Why are we here at all? I mean, what's the point? I mean, if everything is in another space, how do you envision now, after all these visions that you have, where are we now, and where are...
It is about becoming aware that we are conscious creators, that nothing is fixed and there is no linear history, or everything we were told and our beliefs create. So, kind of finding out that every limitation is illusion.
Yeah.
And even physical age, because at one point we may be able, and this is where, to completely, the cell is basically immortal. This was shown in the 80s. It is just the water it is flowing in that makes the degeneration. So at one point we may be able to shapeshift, to teleport, to create out of mind pyramids and things, and know how the law of attraction and activating all we are creating out of
America,
out of the heart.
Can sit with us. If you want to learn something.
To take a photograph.
Yeah. And I think it's about. The whole oneness wants to find out about itself, and for me it feels like we are moving toward a convergence point where not only our reality but many very similar realities also are shifting towards, where it really becomes like a metamorphosis, where we would not where then in all at once biologically is released 5-MeO-DMT, and what then in me activates itself automatically without consuming is then salvia. And this would be what humans call pole shift, dimension shift, that for just a glimpse of a second there is no observer, there is no consciousness fixing anything. It is like this, and in this moment of death and birth at the same time, the whole could become aware, and afterwards it would be like only awakened creatures, and we know that we are part of the one, and we can create universes and switch places, and so and also one theory is that we are still kind of in the cosmic mother's womb, and we are hallucinating this dream reality before really being born of fully aware.
So how about this what they call extraterrestrial? Are they also kind of maybe more advanced being who managed to sort of overcome this, the laws that we now obey, and they are able to go from one reality to another?
Yes, but nothing external. There is only one consciousness that never had been anything
older.
But yeah, then in this variety, and the more we lift our frequency, the more we can connect to this already. That it is like in the fourth dimension, we can get transmissions from different and also kind of states of our future beings. That's why so many feel that the pranic state is what we will, where evolution goes. It just
So, what do you think is happening in the pranic state? I mean, how these people feed themselves, so to say? How do they get their matter replaced?
I think that the cells activate the same what happens in the Wim Hof breathing method. The Iceman who just walked in boxer shorts at the Mount Everest and teaches thousands of people to withstand cold, and it is a breathing method where you put in so much oxygen, then the cells get oxygen saturated, and then you hold the breath for 1 minute, 2 minutes, and suddenly you realize, hey, that this is also very interesting, and within this breath holding, you hear then the DMT, you can get optics, that's why cells don't make it while driving or something, and with this then active, you can control heat, and you will not again. This is what I also experienced in winter. I drank ayahuasca, I went in the snow, And I could produce, like, the bees over a radius of meters. It was really warm, like an oven around me. But only in the second half of the experience, where I also had the experience of not having a body anymore, but everything being vibrating like the body of a bee. I could transform every cell into kind of a bee or something, and they would vibrate, and it would get so warm. And even the temperature in my room then when before was frozen, it was so stunning. And this is my theory that for breatharians also, when you go really long without water, when you go to the limits, and it is also known, you scientifically shown, that when you add DMT to cells, that they longer can get without they don't need oxygen. They maintain. And the interesting thing about when you have a breakthrough is you completely are not anymore in a physical form. You are interdimensional, and in this state, you don't need to breathe anymore. This is because when you smoke DMT, you learn to hold the breath very long, because the longer you hold it, the more intense it gets. But suddenly you realize, hey, you feel like you're ether, like Einstein called it, and you're breathing through the cells like in a liquid. And then even the word breatharian doesn't make sense anymore, because it is not via the lungs.
Physical food, yeah, and lungs.
I had one experience. Normally, when you drink ayahuasca, everything gets closed. You don't want even anything to drink or anything. You just can get the water through the air, through like a tree that is absorbing outside the experience, to be transformed into a tree, into a stone where the gravity is upside down, and suddenly it draws you to the walls. Or also being all the surface. And in one experience, I drank 2 liters before. I don't know why I didn't, but I had a lot of water in me. And during the experience, I felt like being underwater and the water filtrating through my body, going through me, and everywhere. And after 4 hours, I was standing up and habitually thought I maybe would have to pee, but the bladder was completely empty. It was, and I was feeling so happy about it, because this is the most thing I wish for when I also make dark cave experiences. And the only thing you wish for when you go, then you lie down and you make everything perfect. And when you're in the state, you're there for like 100,000 years, what you experience on information, and you won't never be disturbed again by any body functions or something, and you completely see how your body regulates itself. And you, if you want, you would never have to, like the yogis that are sitting in the mountain, that would never have to move again. It's really, really. Weil ich jetzt nämlich meine Arbeit niederlege und mich auf die Höhle vorbereite, kommen dann auch noch ein paar Bilder, dass man sich einstimmen kann. Stille, Dunkelheit, Fasten, Verbindung zu allen höheren Welten. Enthalte dich der Worte, bis du die Sehnsucht der Mitteilung überwunden hast. Enthalte dich der Speisen, bis du die Sehnsucht nach Speisen überwunden hast. Vollständige Ablösung.
do you do that? All in Germany at home?
In Germany at home on my own. I even wrote the book without meeting a shaman. This just happened afterwards. And it is very easy. It is legal material. The plant material is legal, and it is very gray zone because the police don't know what it. They are looking really for different substances, and the public image about it. It gets so much more better and better. And for some weeks ago was also ayahuasca conference in Spain with a lot of indigenous people and scientists to place it much more also in the health system. And there is one more very interesting thing I want to show you. There's a German physicist called Gabi Müller, and she wrote a book, Viva Vortex. It's unfortunately up to now only in German. She really made it, not like me, pseudo. She really made it physically, and what she did is she put X to the power of X, X and the and she used complex non-numbers, the wave function, and she put it recursively in itself. She made a Kopplung with a twin method. She just coupled Z to the power to Z minus one, mm-hmm. puts it back like in a torus, and both interact. So this was her simple formula, and it is. Basically, X to the power of X is a cable tree of 4, 4, 4, and then you another cable tree with 4, 4, 4, and you get and okay. then another cable tree. This is what it does. And the also, and she also digged out the work of lead beaters and who were 100 years before the physicist, describing correctly. This is also so interesting that phi can be depicted just like this, just
really,
just with
once.
Exactly, fraction, yeah, fraction of fraction of fraction. And this is the work of alchemists and mysticists who, in 1908, occult chemistry predicted correctly the properties of matter. Antimatter, atomic weight, structure of over 100 of elements correctly,
really?
And it was later was shown as true, and they just connected to the molecules via astral view and occult methods, and they also say that the Ur Adam is, this is what he could see in his visions, that you have two of these atoms, one flowing left-handed and one flowing right-handed, and originally it is in a rainbow color, and also all the chords of the tones, and you have three main strings, and it is three main strings, and you have tubuli running around. I was really stunned by this picture, because in my first DMT experience I really saw like being in the middle of this and swirling around where all symbols and numbers shown to me. And he, Edwita, could switch in seven astral bodies. They also said that it is vice versa. Matter is the non-being of substance. So, like, vacuumed out, so they could see the 95%, not the 5%. These few pages are very interesting to read in English, and it's much more easy.
How did you manage to translate all this? Once again, does it take a lot of time? Or?
No, Google, within 30 days the whole book was in English.
Really?
Google Translate helped, and I just read over it, and I would love to translate her book in English, because it is the interesting thing about when she puts X to the power of X, what then comes in the pictures are spider-like creatures, and she depicts the skull.
Yeah.
with eye bones. Correctly here you have the skull.
Yeah.
And she also depicts eyes. And on other pictures, butterflies, small insect forms, organs.
Just by playing with numbers.
Just by X to the power of X with form, she creates life forms. And the most interesting thing about this is it does not need DNA for this. Without DNA, the life structure is created. And I was most stunned when I saw this picture. Because this is what Salvianauts will say, like, hey, this is the multiverse reality symbol that happens to me, that the perspective splits up and you see on really exactly layers, and you have black space in between. You never before saw any black, but this is blacker than black. And it is here. It is just zoomed into.
Yeah.
Sipper. And again, you have like it is watching it.
Amazing.
And it is just with X to the power of X. And what Salvia does is cloning. It is also X to the power of X.
Mm.
So it was done like this is the first selfie of the multiverse code of reproduction of parallel. Stacked universes, so this was a really kind of amazing analogy to.
And how did she come to that? Just by left brain, or was she also taking? Is she a mathematician?
She's physicist, and she really makes it with all the proofs and all the correct. She made a scientific work out of it, but she wrote it also in a style that everyone of the awakened consciousness. She also quotes Anastasia and Gautama Rasadin, and she speaks about how to solve the radioactive problem, how we could heal this, and also the aggregate states. That there are 7 aggregate states, like in the old Vedic system. Not only liquid and gas and etheric, but over etheric, under atomic and atomic, and this cube, and she says how this whole organism is created by cooling down and heating up and cooling down and heating up, how out of this Ur-Adam is then created protons, molecules, our DNA, organs, up to villages, up to solar system scales, and she says that the asymmetric is the thriving force. There would no process be in a completely balanced out system. It's the same like universe is left-handed, in the spin in the end, gyro. Spin, so it's also why the face is always kind of asymmetric. This is very interesting to get this vice versa,
okay.
and she also tries to explain teleportation, and how Anastasia does it through defocusing, or she has several theories, and also explains chakras. And tornadoes, and she says that many of the physical things are not needed, but the Auftriebskraft dann is the buoyancy. Is one of the main. So with this you even do not need gravity, because it's just then density differences that cause
the tornado.
When it is low density, then it is more up. When it is higher density, then it is more down. So and like with the bird, there is the buoyancy. It is called. And
you were doing the experiments. Your experience with bees, and I was thinking very often of all these small insects, flies and bees and even birds. Where do they get energy to fly? It's impossible. They fly like their wings like 100 times per second or more.
The homie, this big bee, this big fat one, when you calculate it, she would never be able to fly because she's much too heavy and she has so small wings. She couldn't not, but she does.
She does.
So this is.
So there is some miracle with their wings.
Yes.
Something that defeats gravity or defeats aerodynamics.
Krebennikov burned. He never told which kind of insect sort it is. He did not want people to deform it or to destroy nature because of what he found out. But he gave several clues how he made it, and afterwards I saw videos on levitation and lifting gravity, and they were doing the same stuff with this. So what I can see with the eyes is that when you take a wing of such a beautiful creature, that it has a frequency field like this, very strong electromagnetic field. So it seems like having our own sphere, and bats, for example, are on prana during whole winter. I was in a cave for 3 weeks with bats, and they never eat. They just hang there and sometimes they fly and they make a noise like a bottle that is not completely closed, very very high. But they would not care looking for food. And I also felt this for some bee tribes that are very high in frequency, that they just collect the honey and they don't need it for themselves. And it also felt like that bees are all the time in this what I call DMT space, in this awareness and perception.
So they're smarter than us. They know more than us.
Kind of, yeah. They're at least helping us to raise our frequencies. And it is. When I was living with the bees, I was only on ayahuasca and honey. And in the ayahuasca, my cells got through the white light that then splits up and rainbow colors. They got all nutrition, all what, however you call it. I did not lose weight, I kept all my muscles, I was in perfect health, I needed only 2 hours sleep, woke up 1 hour before sunlight, and I'm also a daylight shaman, so when other people have lunch, I drink, and I need only so small portions. This is the nice thing about the tolerance drops, because it's just a remembrance of the body, and the rest. I can also then do the tongue mudra, the kachari mudra, just a little bit, focusing on the pineal gland, but it's also produced in the lungs, and then I experience the secret secretion nectar that it is then body's own produced. And this is also what Santos Bunanachi tells, how humans in earlier times managed to get hundreds of years old. He says, when the moon is in the sign of your star pattern, then there is a seed planted in your solar plexus, or in your sacral chakra, and it then rises, and he then explains all religious stories according to body anatomy, that it is just a mapping of words. We have 33 spines, like the 33 years of Jesus' life. Then he was crucified, so the seed is planted, and it goes up, but you have to be aware of it, and you do not have to have any sex or orgasmic energy, because then it would be a ring. Also shamanic doings only work when you keep your energies with your state. And it goes up, and then it is crucified in the medulla oblongata, is the anatomic word for this thing sitting directly over your spinal cord, connecting to the, and in this center, this fluid just rests for 2.5 days. Then there it is crucified, means potented to the 2,500 fold power, but during this time nothing happens, and after exactly 2.5 days, like Jesus was there 2.5 days, then you have the secret chamber which the pineal gland in the middle is surrounded by 12 nerve strings, like the 12 apostles. This is Ra, this is Christ within. And you have Joseph and Maria, Bethlehem, and the star is the pectoral gland, the pineal gland, and the pectoral gland we have right behind our eyes. We have two glands. And these are then producing milk and honey, DMT, and another kind of celestial nectar, where when even one drop of this touches the nervous system, it lightens up and it instantaneously heals all illness, and the blood gets also completely cleaned and newly refreshed. And he says every human can body arm release this every month. You just have to look, check the dates within 3 days. Be aware of this, do fasting, do meditation on it, be aware of it. And I did this 2 months in November and December last year. That I was very aware during this date, and I did also not consume food during this time. I was just to find out. And middle in the night at 3 o'clock, I was suddenly in deep, deep, wonderful DMT experience, body on, and I also had a micro miniature drop of this golden nectar, where suddenly all my nervous system lighted up and felt so amazing. And I tried it 3 times, and 2 times it worked.
Amazing.
So I was also thinking about in the right state, one could really measure something, but often also
Yeah, that's completely new dimension. You wrote most of it in your book.
Yes, most of it in the book, and also the newest one, I made a movie series called Mandela Effect. What really connects visible how history already changed, there are hundreds of things in it. It started with Nelson Mandela dying in prison in the 80s, and suddenly he's alive until 2013. Then the state of liberty, hundreds of people were up in the torch. Now Wikipedia states that it is closed for 100 years and that the Germans attacked it in 1916, and no one can remember this. It was a huge attack of German terrorist attack, and you have logos, you have minor things in movies changing. Darth Vader never said, "Luke, I am your father," he says. And even the actor that does not remember the movie scene like it is now. It is. And the funny thing about this, it is the awakening, really not anymore being shamanic vision, but really people you get goosken, and it has a frequency like I would have to middle in the night watch. I'm a Star Trek fan, and I would have to watch in fast forward the whole series again, because now Captain Picard is holding in over 80 episodes a crystal in his hand, and I watched it hundreds of times, and now he's having a crystal in his hand. It's like things. And it is in the end really connecting to the multidimensional awareness, the awakening, and also the biggest final was then that I found Mandela effects that are one-to-one like Sylvia Tripp reports, where you see a double of you, where the neighborhood from, or some say, this is not my husband anymore, or I teleported 3 blocks, or one guy who took an overdose of salvia, and this should not be smoked with fire. This is the whole humanity or the whole psychonauts did it wrong, because fire is not her element, it is water, and with fire it can be get really too crust, traumatic, and this guy was, he thought it is synthetic wheat, he didn't know it was salvia, and he smoked it, and within 45 seconds of our reality, he lived the life he was a man was nearly being drowned, putting out of the border, being put back to life and friends around, and he was not in Alaska anymore, but in Texas. And he first thought this would end. It was just astound how super photorealistic it is, and also making fun about the people, that they are really realistic. And he went to sleep, and then next morning knocking, why do you not show up for work? And in the end, he spent 8 years within this life in Texas.
Teleported,
but like a parallel life. He was this other person, and it took him 4 years to then the doctor said it may be amnesia or brain damage because of his near drowning experience. And he sought his old life. He was looking for his old life, but he couldn't find it anymore. So he was finally thinking that this old life was a hallucination. And after 8 years, he just went with his friends, and he carried a box, and suddenly the ground below him turned into a whirlpool, and he was same way as he was sucked in into this reality. He was sucked back into his body and his friends around at Christmas evening. One calling the doctor, and family really being mad at him for doing drugs on Christmas, and he was 40, and since then he has, and this guy was then asked again if it was just imagined or true, but he confirmed that it was, and many, this is what Dennis McKenna also tells, that this is not so uncommon, that you have a period of 5 months, for example, that you live another life, and
that's crazy.
It's really crazy. Yeah.
I want to.
When you give me your mail address,
yes.
I can send you some crucial links, and then it's thank you for. All right. I'll be looking forward for a second part of this science-related series. I continued the talk, and it will come an extra video when it's done. I'd feel so happy that all this dense information is shared now, even more compact, up to the point, speaking out of me, through me. I'm just a channel, a medium, a tool. In the end, I'm just the link. And now, as afterlude, we hear in background the beautiful music by Frank Droll, Bacanoa Creations. Join him on SoundCloud. He does epic, deep, psybeant space music. And what you see now is a picture show of the folders on my desktop. For 3 years that I collected it, and they're called Understanding Physics, Microorganisms, Neural Network, Field Torus. This whole folder and research I did in 2017 and 16. When I first got in contact with DMT, it was before I wrote Lucid Dream. And originally the idea behind Lucid Dream was to make 4 versions of the book. One for scientists, where I could place all the research that I did over 1 year, and I really googled and found out so many stuff that would have filled another 200 pages more that is not to be found in the book. But could unfold. So here you see it now, just the pictures. And there originally should have been 4 versions, one for scientists, one for children, because the original source file of Lucid Dream is a PowerPoint file where everyone can change, and it is very easy to make it beautiful and impact. So one for scientists, one for children, one for conservative. This is where the order of the pages would have been just switched, where it would not begin with fuck you all and my wildlife and rave and drug stories. And the other version would have been für Fabelwesen und Revolutionäre, for fabulous creatures and revolutes. And this is actually the version that is now realized. We don't need to put so much more effort in it. I just want to let you know. Here we go, understanding physics, clear language. Yes, I really love to study physics, especially quantum physics, and I was interested in where the logic ends, where we cannot grasp with our human common sense anything anymore. This is where things get interesting. So here we go. This is really a lot of pictures, but it feels so good because this is what I collected now over 4 years, and it's kind of a backup selection of what is about to want to have impact. Yeah, and here I add also, when I was studying physics, for the exams, we were allowed to take one single paper with us where we could write formulas on the front and on the back. And here you see, it's art, what I prepared for the exams for Festkörper Physik, solid state physics, quantum mechanics 1 and 2. And I did it for every lesson, and I learned most during writing these, these most condensed notes.
Gurgor Telkoisir. Tena turre. Tena ento lie omenta. Tena teruan. Quel caima. Quel esta. Quel esta. Quel esta. Thank you. Nice, I am Lumi.